to order as Councilwoman Keyes heads to the dais. Let's please rise for the Pledge of Allegiance to be delivered by Detective Charles Reimer.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Thank you. Please remain standing. Our invocation this evening will be delivered by Reverend Cheryl Sejour.
Good evening, Vice Mayor Galvin, council members, and city staff. Let us pray. Father of heaven and earth, we thank you. We know that the earth is yours and the fullness thereof. And we honor you tonight here in the city of North Miami. And we thank you that you are forever faithful to bless those who bless you. Therefore, we invoke your blessing over the leaders represented in this council chamber and for the community leaders and for the North Miami Police Department that serve this wonderful city. We ask you to bless them. We ask you to protect them. We know that you are a covenant-keeping God, and we thank you, Lord, that you have promised that when we lack wisdom, we can ask you for wisdom and you give it to us. And so, Lord, we ask that you would give wisdom to every council member, to every decision that is made in this chamber, for your glory and for your honor. Amen.
Amen.
Please be seated. City Clerk Michael Etienne will do the call to order roll call.
Mayor Joseph. Vice Mayor Galvin.
Here.
Councilwoman Keyes.
Here.
Councilman Bien-Aimé.
Here.
Councilman DeZume.
Here.
Mayor, we have a quorum.
All right, thank you very much. We've got one special presentation now, so if the council would join us down at the front of the dais, we're going to recognize our employee of the quarter for fall 2016.
Start it. Good evening. I'd like to recognize Danielle Gomer as the officer of the quarter. As the civilian employee of the quarter. I'm so used to saying officer of the quarter. She was recommended by Assistant Chief Larry Jariga and Major Francia Burden, who cannot be here tonight, but it is my honor to present her the award. In 1992, she came to the city of North Miami as a crime scene tech. In 2013, she took over our property room, and in her tenure in the property room, she's been instrumental in reorganizing and has worked dedicated countless hours into turning around our property room and making it now one of the pride and accomplishments and joys of our department. This quarter, what she was nominated for was that she completed a 100% inventory of the property room, and during the 100% inventory of the property room, they identified $44,000 in funds that were made available for the general fund and deposited to the general fund for the city. In addition, her high degree of integrity and loyalty to the department made the process go smoothly, easily, and it's been a pleasure to work with her. And I'll turn it over to Chief Gary Eugene to present the plaque to her.
I believe with all fairness, we should ask him. No. And I'd like to recognize him, former chief of North Miami Beach. And he's here, that's your half. And so I'm going to pass him the baton, at least just for tonight, to be the chief of North Miami and present it to your half one.
No,
Go ahead. I wanted to confirm you. We are asking them. No, there is nothing to read. But seriously, it is a pleasure. It is not very often you find someone so dedicated, and you don't realize the way the property unit was when she took over, and she did it with a passion, with a love, not only to the police department, but it seems like obviously it was for the entire city. And we are very, very proud of you when you got nominated for the position. And having said that, the plaque is a very simple one from the city of North Miami, but it is on behalf of the entire staff of our city. Thank you again. Congratulations. Something else additionally, there is a gift card for you to be spent as you like. If you don't want it, I'm just curious. Oh, yes, she has to.
And I'll make it quick. I just want to thank the council, Chief Tariga, Chief Eugene, for nominating me, and just explain to you that we work as a team, and I do have a couple of people that were very instrumental in helping me with this process. Maria Salveria, who works in the records department, she helped me research old cases. And Jackie Finkel, who works in dispatch and also helped me run subjects, run people to see where they lived so I could try to find their property to get it back to them. And my work husband, who is not here, Steve Melvin, he helps me out a lot in the property room. And of course, my husband, who puts up with my sometimes late hours and grumpy disposition sometimes. Thank you very much.
And before we continue with the rest of the meeting, we want to just give a point of recognition to a class of students here from Alonzo and Tracy Morning Senior High School. If you guys wave your hand. Glad to have the Sharks here learning how government works tonight. So we're going to move on with the meeting, and we're going to have our city events done by Cassandra Timothy.
Good evening, Vice Mayor, Council, staff, and members of the public. My name is Cassandra Timothy, Public Information Officer, and I have the pleasure of sharing all of the exciting events coming up in the City of North Miami in this brand new year. Join the City of North Miami as we salute the work and vision of Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. through spoken word, song, and dance performances by students from our local schools on Wednesday, January 11th in the Moca Plaza, beginning at 6 p.m. The event is presented by the North Miami University Relations Board. Join the North Miami City Council and Planning Commission on Thursday, January 12th to discuss the future look of our city by updating the land development regulation and zoning map. The meeting will take place right here in our council chambers beginning at 5:30 p.m. The meeting is the first of a series of community meetings seeking your valuable input. The City of North Miami is the proud sponsor of the third annual Zoe Winter Groove 5K and Family Health and Wellness Day. Join Alonzo Morning Pro Athletes on Saturday, January 14th. The day will begin at 8 a.m. with the 5K run/walk and immediately followed by the Family Health and Wellness Groove. Adults and children will have an opportunity to participate in fit courses, obstacle course training, Zumba and yoga classes, free health screening, and more. The Get in Gear Community Bike Ride takes place on the second Saturday of every month. Join your neighbors on Saturday, January 14th at 8 a.m. in the Mocha Plaza. The ride departs at 8:30 a.m. sharp. The ride will also include a special visit to the third annual Zoe's Winter Groove Day. Tickets are almost sold out for the third annual Mayor's Gala presented by the Police Athletic League of North Miami. Enjoy an evening of illusions on Saturday, January 28th, beginning at 6:30 at the FIU Coven Center. The event will include live entertainment, cuisine, cocktails, and surprises throughout the night. Enjoy decorative floats, elaborate costumes, cultural food, live entertainment, and dancing along 125th Street from 6th to 12th Ave on Sunday, January 29th at North Miami Mardi Gras, hosted by Papa Keith from 103.5 The Beat, beginning at 1 p.m. Popular Caribbean artists such as Shaggy, Sweet Mickey, T-Vice, Gabel will be joined by other well-known acts at North Miami Free Mardi Gras Festival presented by Fahrenheit. Stay tuned by watching our free governmental programming, NOMI TV, available 24 hours through our city's website, www.northmiamifl.gov. Like the City of North Miami on Facebook, follow at NOMI News on Twitter, and download the My NOMI app. Thank you.
Thank you, Cassandra. For those of you in the know, that is the Honorable Sweet Mickey. We'll now move on to city projects. No city projects update tonight, so we're on the consent agenda. By the way, were there any orders, any items that needed to be deleted or added for this evening, Mr. Manager?
Through the Vice Mayor, no, we do not have any changes to the agenda. Thank you.
I like this. All right, consent agenda. Is there a motion to approve consent? It's been moved and seconded.
Yeah.
All those in favor?
Wait.
I need to record the motions, the seconds, and the votes. So I need to get a name.
Sure.
So who?
Motion by Councilman DeSulme, second by Councilman Bien-Aimé.
Okay, 1 second. So I have a motion made by Councilman DeSulme to approve the consent agenda.
Say it right, Mr. Clark.
And the second was made by?
Councilman Bien-Aimé.
Councilman Bien-Aimé. All in favor?
Aye.
All opposed? Item passes with a 4-0 vote. Tab D. Proposed resolution of the Mayor and City Council of the City of North Miami, Florida, authorizing the City Manager to issue a purchase order in the amount of $122,000 to LYTX, Inc., piggybacking an agreement between the United States General Services Administration and LYTX, Inc., under the authorized Federal Supply Information Technology Schedule Price List, General Purpose Commercial Information Technology Equipment, Software, and Services. Solicitation number GS-35F-0623S for the installation of 100 drive cameras with video event recorders for the city's drive cam program for selected service vehicles used and operated by Code Compliance, Parks and Recs, and the Public Works Department for a term of 1 year, providing for an effective date and for all other purposes. That was tab D.
All right. Staff, is there a presentation to be made under tab D?
Very quickly, a brief presentation.
Sure thing. Good evening, Mr. Vice Mayor, Council Members. Alberto Estrada, Purchasing Department. The item that you have before you is staff's recommendation to approve a piggyback of a federal government General Services Administration with a company named LYTX for drive cam services for the city. As included and noted in our staff's council report, the administration embarked on a trial program approximately 8 months last year in which we implemented the drive cam program. The goals of this trial program was for the administration to be able to better document and evaluate the incidents of poor driving by city employees, to assist them in improving driving behavior, to promote and encourage safe driving skills, and to significantly reduce the possibility of preventable accidents while operating city vehicles. This program was spearheaded by our risk management department, and in fact by Ms. Karen Muir, manager of the risk management department, who is here this evening with me. The results of this 8-month trial program were absolutely remarkable. As included in the report, the reductions in vehicle collisions, traffic violations, and unsafe driving patterns by city employees were rather significant. Just to note a few, 74% reduction in collisions or accidents, 42% reduction in driver violations, et cetera. In addition to these results, staff anticipates, and it is what is driving this recommendation, that this DriveCam program will continue to yield the following benefits for the city: improve driver safety to avoid preventable accidents and also injuries to city employees, significant cost savings to the city resulting from reduced liability claims, vehicle damage, workers' compensation, personal injury claims due to the DriveCam program. In fact, the implementation of the DriveCam program has already contributed to a significant reduction in claims from fiscal year 15 to fiscal year 16, a 68% reduction in liability payouts. The DriveCam video can also serve to exonerate city employees who may not be at fault in vehicle-related accidents, thereby protecting not only the employees but also the city from frivolous lawsuits and medically related claims. The annual cost of this program is, for the first year, $122,000. It includes the hardware, installation, and subscription to the DriveCam program. In addition to this, you have also four additional optional years to renew this contract. And I should add, as I mentioned, not only Ms. Karen Muir from the Risk Management Department, but also from the company, there is a representative here present. So if the council members have any questions, I'll be glad to entertain them. I'm sure he'll be also glad to answer your questions.
Thank you, Mr. Estrada. Mr. Manager.
Just very quickly, I did want to specifically acknowledge Risk Management, Karen, her staff. They've been doing a hell of a job this last 8 or 9 months on me personally about going to our safety meetings. This item has been used as a preventative tool and not a disciplinary tool, and I just want to make sure that's on the record with the council tonight. So thank you.
Thank you. Before we open it up to council questions, is there anybody from the public who'd like to be heard on item number D, tab number D? Seeing nobody, council questions, Mr. DeSulme.
Yes, sir, Vice Mayor. Quick question. I think I asked you that, Mr. Manager, during our briefing. So it's $122,000 for the first year. In my understanding of this technology, it only records the last 5 seconds or 10, 30 seconds of if the person hit the brake. Is the representative from the, through you, Mr. Vice Mayor,
sure.
I'd like to ask the representative from the company just one minor question. So let's just say, and I'm just asking this out of the blue.
No problem.
What if I get into the vehicle and shot somebody and I'm driving? So if I don't stop, technically it won't record that previous activity until I stop. It'll be the last 30 seconds of whatever that occurred prior to that, the technology will pick up. Is that correct?
That is correct, Councilmember. The way the device works is when you slam on the brakes or you're speeding or you hit a curb or something happens erratic with the vehicle, okay, then it goes back 8 seconds in time to see why we got in that situation and what are the coaching or training opportunities we can derive of that. And then it'll record for four more seconds after the situation, and then shuts off.
Okay. One last question, sir.
Yes, sir.
So, 8 seconds, so the amount total, if we like this program, apparently is doing some wonderful work. So it should be for the next 4 years, approximately $300,000, if we decide to move forward for the next 4 years.
Yes, sir. Build on an annual basis. Mm-hmm. As long as the city is happy with the program, you'll continue to renew year over year.
Okay. And does the camera become ours at any point? Or is
yes, sir. Part of the $122,000 investment on the front end is you are buying the devices that we have installed in the city vehicles today. So we're transferring title from Lytx,
the
company name Lytx, over to the city. Yes, sir.
Okay, and last question, sir. So the annual fee would be a management type of fee or technical support type of fee, the $46,000? Each additional year after?
Yes, sir. All of the above. So it's all of the subscription, the cellular cost, our team to come in and analyze, review, analyze, and score all of the events that come out of the city of North Miami. And then we work with Karen and her team to focus on the highlights in terms of safety training. Yes, sir.
Thank you.
All right. Anybody else on the dais have questions for
yes.
the?
How many vehicles going to be, we're going to install those cameras?
It's approximately 100 vehicles.
Mr. Distrati, can you say that on the microphone? I'm sorry for that.
It's, council member, it's 100 vehicles that are earmarked for this. Right. Initially, 100 vehicles.
Including police vehicles?
No, there are no police vehicles. These are service vehicles.
Okay. Another question. Why you keep piggybacking? So it's almost all your contract or piggyback from
this particular contract was something that was in place on a pilot, so that's why it was piggybacked.
Not talking about this,
but in general, the purchasing director and I actually have had a conversation. I think you made the same comment towards the end of last year, and we're working to do our own. More of our own direct procurements. As a matter of fact, in the next council meeting and going forward, you will see more of solicitations that we control from, that we do in-house, rather, I should say, as opposed to piggybacking on other contracts. The general answer to why we piggyback, a lot of times it is financially better pricing and a more efficient process, because if you recall, when you put out a bid, sometimes it could take several months to get it out and back in. And I think you guys know from last meeting, we withdrew an item because we got a protest bid on an item, and that potentially holds us up 60, 90, 100 days when we go through the process. So a lot of factors that go into making the decision to piggyback.
How many cities in Miami-Dade County have in that program?
Within the county, City of Miami is using it within several of their departments. And then outside of the county and within Florida, there's probably a dozen cities and about six or seven different counties using it.
City of Miami incident, just so you know on the record, I don't know if you recall the garbage truck that drove over the side of I-95 about a year ago. They were able to determine it was driver error. Luckily, the driver was, he's safe and he's back at work, but this recording device actually recorded what happened, so it does work.
All right.
Councilman DeSoto again. Mr. Vice Mayor. No, it's not relating to that. But going back to the piggyback, I know we had conversation about it. My only issue with it is, once you do that, you kind of leave the small business from our community at least to participate. From the entire process. Thank you.
Thank you. Gentlemen, if you don't have any questions, Councilwoman Keyes?
No.
All right. There are no more questions from the council. It's in order for us to have a motion to approve.
So do we have a motion to approve tab D?
I'll make a motion to approve it.
Motion by Councilwoman Keyes. Is there a second?
Second.
Okay, I have a motion made by Councilwoman Keyes to approve tab D. That motion was seconded by Councilman DeZume. All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
All opposed? Item passes with a 4-0 vote.
Councilman DeZume had a question.
Yes, sir. Each year, when you say optional, it will come back to us to remind us? Or are you just going to include it in the budget?
Based on the dollar amount, I have to bring it back because it's over my $25,000.
Oh, okay. Okay. I just want to make sure. Thank you.
All right, thank you. Thank you, Mr. Distrade, and thank you. Students from Alonzo Mourning, you've come to probably the shortest council meeting in the last 20 years. Normally these bad boys stretch on till midnight. You're getting really lucky tonight, so tell Mr. Hoover he was a good guy. We're now moving down, with there not being any other ordinances, quasi-judicial items, ordinances, or petitions, to Citizens Forum. The floor is now open for anybody from the public who wishes to come forward. You have 2 minutes on any item of your choosing. Public forum is open. And unless Beverly is jumping up real quick. Okay.
Hi, good evening. Beverly Hilton, 12495 Northwest 6th Avenue. Actually, two questions. One for Alex. But District 4, regarding the...
Sume, okay, I got you.
Yeah, Councilman Sume.
I'm messing with you.
Okay. Chinatown. People are saying it's dead. Is it still going? Okay, answer that later. And the other question, follow up on the Mardi Gras. How is it going? Just like to have some feedback.
Okay. We'll allow those questions to be answered under their respective reports.
Sure. Absolutely. We're not going to hear anything about it because the process right now, is my understanding, Rasha, back there, it's we're working on the master plan, which is going to take about 6 months. There was actually a quite lengthy article a week ago. No, it's not. It's not dead. But no. So you're not going to hear nothing between now and I guess the end of June. But there is opportunity for community meetings and interaction for the community to come out. So we encourage you to come out and participate. Thank you.
Thank you, Ms. Zulin. Constituent Forum is still open.
William Prevotel, 11950 North Bayshore Drive. This is a very brief meeting, is it not? Tonight marks 10 days before the inauguration, and I hope encourage everybody to, since we are leaving so early, to watch tonight's broadcast by our current president, Barack Obama, and for what I feel is an incredible job that he's done over these last 8 years. With that in mind, I would like to reiterate that we were hoping to make some sort of dedication to our current president and administration here at the city of North Miami and the good that it's done to many people of this community. And I still have trying to work something out with our city manager and assistant city manager, possibly so that it could be the fountain at in front of MoCA Museum, which is somewhat an O shape. And we're offering to fund the some sort of bronze plaque device and some sort of acknowledgement. And that would be greatly appreciated. I look forward to communicating with some positive response. Particularly, I'd like to a place of prominence such as MoCA Plaza. And thank you very much for your consideration and look forward to this. The election results do not curtail our interest in acknowledging this administration. And I wish us all the best going forward. Thank you.
Thank you. Is anybody else who'd like to speak under Citizens Forum? Going once, seeing nobody, Citizens Forum is now closed. We'll move on to council reports. Oh, Citizens Forum? Citizens Forum is reopened. Sir, please state your name and address for the record. You have 2 minutes to speak on any topic you'd like.
T. Joni C. Zare, 1051 Northeast 125th Street. I'm just here to let the councilman be aware that I run a basketball organization in the city of North Miami. And my kids are student athletes. A lot of them are Haitian American. And we're having a difficult time as far as getting a facility because we are outdoors practicing like the day tonight was rained out. And I'm here to speak on behalf of the kids that, you know, we're working hard trying to stay out of trouble, stop the violence. And I would like to know what the city of North Miami can do to help us, you know, stay off the streets. And far as like a lot of kids can't afford uniforms, shoes, they can't play basketball in shoes and et cetera, you know, the basketball equipment in general. I would like to know what can y'all do to help us out? Anybody?
Sure. If you're finished, it looks like Mr. Sori wants to say something. Yeah. Mr. Sori, was that?
Through the manager, we do have our Parks and Recreation Director in the back, Mr. Derek Corker. He'll have his card and he'll be able to answer any questions with you using our facilities and possible rental of our facilities and the process that you would have to go through.
Well, you know, I'm up here now. I would like to see if I can get a waiver on the rental facilities because I don't been down that route.
Well, there is an actual form that you would fill out to get a waiver to use the facility as well.
Okay.
It will come, and once you fill out the waiver, it does come to the manager's office, and we'll take care of it from there.
All right. Thanks a lot.
Thank you. Thanks for what you do for our kids. Anybody else, Citizens Forum? All right. Citizens Forum is closed. We'll now go to council reports, and I'll go ladies first. Councilwoman Keyes.
Happy New Year, everybody, and happy birthday, Mrs. Hilton. I believe it's your birthday. Our first speaker out there, is it your birthday? Happy birthday.
35.
She forgot? I have no reports.
All right.
Councilman
Bien-Aimé.
I just want to wish everyone Happy New Year. And hopefully the city of North Miami and all the residents will have a good year, 2017. About the resolution to ban pesticide in the city, and can you give me a quick update on it?
Absolutely. I know at the meeting, I guess a couple meetings ago, we had our an expert come and talk to us about one chemical. That's the foundational chemical in Roundup. What we're doing based on the request you made through the city attorney's office, we are seeking legislation about the city not using certain pesticides, and we'll bring that forth. Addition, the council as a whole gave me direction to have at least host one or two public meetings. So I'll bring the resolution, but we will still have those. We'll still host that meeting.
That's right. The next council, you're going to bring the resolution.
Yeah, right. But we will bring a resolution for your consideration.
Okay. Thank you.
Thank you, Councilman Vienna May. Councilman DeSome.
Yes, sir. I want to wish everyone a happy, healthiest new year. I just wanted to announce tomorrow the Golden Senior Program will be holding its second annual luncheon. And also next week, a delegation from the city of North Miami will be traveling to Haiti to do the inaugural. Doing I know this will be good for you, Mr. Pervitel. Doing the official inauguration in D.C., I'll be way away from D.C. We'll be doing our own inauguration of our newly sister city of Acaire in Haiti. And I am looking forward to that. And I just want to wish everyone again a happy, happy new year. Thank you.
Thank you, Councilman. From my standpoint, of course, happy new year to everybody. I had a constituent by the name of Jose Pichardo who has written in repeatedly about some streetscape improvements on Northeast 11th Court. Between Northeast 123rd and Northeast 125th Streets, through you, Mr. Manager, to our Public Works Department, ask that they please quickly visit. It's been 6 weeks or so since his initial inquiry, and staff is yet to acknowledge that they're looking at it, not looking at it, or doing whatever. And this is separate from the roundabout concern I had over the weekend. This is a totally separate location. Northeast 11th Court between 123rd Street Northeast and Northeast 125th Street. So if anybody could answer Mr. Pichardo's question, I'd be thankful. That's the only report I had, and now we'll move to the city clerk's report. Mr. Etienne?
Thank you, thank you, Vice Mayor. Quick statement. I received a lot of calls on the cell regarding election signs. This is, in fact, election season. We're holding our election roughly 3-4 months from today. That resolution is going to be before the mayor and council, next council meeting. Our sign bonds, in terms of signs, they were ruled unconstitutional by, if I'm not mistaken, the Supreme Court. To date, the City of North Miami council members have not approved a resolution that has replaced our current sign bond resolution so that it can, I guess, pass constitutional muster. So for that reason, at this moment, we have no sign bond. We cannot enforce the sign bond ordinances we currently have in our books. So the only thing I can tell you, if you want to put up your sign, you file your intent to run as a candidate, you can go ahead and put up your sign, but you are still prohibited from putting up your sign on public swells. Do not put it on the public swells, and that's the only announcement I can make regarding the election. If there's anything further, the city attorney would address it. Besides that, happy New Year's, everyone. I know I didn't see you before then, and you guys enjoy your night.
Thank you, Mr.
Kazar. I have a question about this election.
Mr. Kazo, and then we'll come to council.
If I may add, it's not as if there are no rules regarding signs. It's just that all of our rules regarding signs apply to all signs. So that's the constitutional rulings that you can't do anything specific for, let's say, your real estate signs or campaign signs. So what I've instructed code enforcement is whatever you do for signs, you do it for all signs. And so if we prevent real estate agents from putting signs on swales, then we also prevent candidates from putting signs on swales. So the rules will be applied equally across the board, regardless of the language or intent of the sign. So,
Councilman Bienname.
Yeah, my question, Mr. City Clerk, after the election, how long do a candidate have to remove the sign?
You know, that's a very good question. The only thing I can rely on is what the Florida statute requires. Now, it is an ethics violation if you keep your sign passed. If I'm not mistaken, I want to say 30 or 60 days. I'll get the exact date for you, and I'll let you know. But unfortunately, we're not holding checks anymore. Initially, what would happen, you would come in with a $250 sign bond, and if you didn't remove your sign within 30 days of the election, we would use that as the cost for code enforcement of having code enforcement go there and remove your sign. Because we can't charge that sign bond, if you don't remove your sign, the only thing a resident can do is file an ethics complaint. I won't file it, but. So I think you have 30 to 60 days, but I'll find out and I'll get back to you.
But what about code enforcement?
Well, I was gonna, and maybe I'm being too voluntary on this, and this is just me having worked in cities. After the election is done, city looks like crap with all those signs all over the place, so mm-hmm. I would, if you want to give me some direction to go ahead and have the staff just go and remove all the signs, if
the election is, I'm not done.
Sure, Councilman Bien-Aimé still has the floor. Yeah. Councilman Bien-Aimé.
Because the question is, the election, you have some election, we've been over for 4 months, and we still
have signs out.
Signed out. That's the question that I have. Can code enforcement remove them?
What I will do is, by next meeting, we'll have something for you all in terms of some recommendations on signs. Unfortunately, because
not on signs after the election.
No, I'm saying in general on rules with signs. The problem is when the court came out with their ruling, it just kind of threw all the cities in the same boat where we can't do anything regarding signs. So it's not something my office had looked at. But since this has come up tonight, I'll look at it, and next meeting we'll come up.
But I don't see that in other cities. They have regulation where after an election,
right,
you,
all of those
you have a
lot
of time
no
to
longer
remove the sign. We're not talking about before the election, but after.
That was the case everywhere, including here, but that changed when the U.S. Supreme Court ruled our ordinance unconstitutional.
Yeah, but I understand that. But what about the cleanup for the city? And you have signed all over after an election.
Okay. So you'll address that in the comprehensive.
I'll address it, yes. Okay. Yes.
Councilman DeSilme?
Well, my question was, it was specifically that we can't really say campaign. Can it be an ordinance for whoever put up sign? Not targeting election?
That's exactly what it is.
Okay.
I mean, we can make general rules regarding signs. We just can't make rules specifically regarding any type of speech. So we can't make rules specifically for real estate agent signs, or we can't make rules specifically for campaign signs. But again, once the court ruled, it made our laws illegal, so we can't enforce those. So we will come back with some other method of trying to resolve the issues that you all are bringing up tonight.
Okay. Any further questions on this topic from council?
No.
All right, we'll move to the city attorney's report. Mr. Cazzo.
The only thing I'd like to mention, and you all know, is I received about a week ago now a letter of resignation from my deputy city attorney, Roland Galdos. It's unfortunate. My job just becomes that much harder. But he's leaving to go to the City of Miami Parking Authority. So we wish him well. He's been here for 10 years. We're doing a little thing for him tomorrow within the office, but we're going to ask him to come back when the mayor and the entire council's here to send him off correctly. So we'll do something at the next meeting for him.
Thank you, Mr. Cazzo. they're just debating whether or not tomorrow's event, whether or not that was a surprise. And if it was, so nobody,
My office is taking him out to lunch.
That's what I'm talking about.
All right, city manager's report.
No.
No report, just say I'm well rested and ready to work.
All right, that's a good thing. All right, with there being no other reports to be made, is there a motion to adjourn tonight's meeting? So moved. Is there a second? We're adjourned. See you next meeting.